Be faithful, number one. This is God's expression over the qualities He has gifted you. Bakit? Pinakakalan mo pa siya. Aren't you grateful? Tapos ang response mo, annoyance, or probably you will feel indifferent because He has already expressed. He expressed that God because of His observation. The proximity you had in friendship. That is exactly what the dynamics is asking. Leading friendship to a what? To an affection and later that kind of relationship, romantic relationship. So, probably just put it in the right perspective. Do not be annoyed. Do not feel different. Maintain the friendship. Because after all, you have no certainty. The guy of your choice. Mali mo. May mga nangyari ganyan. Yung babae, halos umayaw na, magkakaw-dodo. And eventually, I have heard many stories of that. Whenever I do forums like this, there will always be many couples who will express talagang mapilit ko itong aking asawa. O may humamas na yung pagsasaga. And eventually, the Bible is true, the persistent. Gain the upper hand. Di ba? You never can. Minsan, nag-comment pa tayo na hindi na deserve yung asawa na. Pwede na kung paano ko wala. Pero ba? Ano yun? Ang mindful. Kaya yung babae, bakit na yung asawa na? Similarly, persistence has taken an upper hand over that. And there was more than just a external appearance.
Okay, so kapag nangyari po pala yun, it's more of yes, self-denial, sanctification process. Amen. Okay, may share niyo po ba? Yes, po. I think hindi dapat yung mag-change na lang. You really need to be the good friend you are with the person. Ang problema kasi na
Amen.
So the next question is this. What can you say about parents being the ones courting for their children? Or parents does not approve of someone you like, which a very good Christian, because they like someone else for you. Will you still pursue your own way or honor your parents?
Parents, in the normal, God would always want your best friend. Are you wondering? As a friend. Let me repeat that. Parents always wanted the best of your friend. That should be the parents. And if ever parents are doing this against your will in favor of someone from you, it is more likely two things are happening. Number one, they cannot see yet a capability in you to choose the rightful person. Second, they are anxious of the future for you. On these two respects, the parents honestly wanted your welfare. So do not pay back with an attitude as if they are controlling you. I would say, have a different perspective to that. Nung anak pa lang ako, ganyan din ang isip ko. When I was still the child, I used to think that the parents are doing it wrong. Well, I'm not saying they're doing it right also. But the point is, it stands on the premise that parents wanted your welfare. And they cannot trust you yet with your decision because there's a better choice, or they are anxious for your future. So what's the best way to handle this? Number one, work hard to prove to your parents that you are already reaching such a level of maturity and responsibility that they can already trust you to make decisions for your benefit. Are you following, friends? Do not just negate the attitude of your parents. It's a symptom that you cannot yet be trusted. Their choices are your choices. Out of experience in their lives may not be congruent to yours. Then be careful of that one. Do not disrespect our parents. Only because they're trying to court someone else. You will never want to say that magagawa. Even if they have to court a need for you instead. Di ba? Summer, are you troubled with that? Are you good? Oh, kung ako yung magulang ni Rachel, and as if we are talking on Adwin, in behalf of Rachel, Adwin, alam mo talaga, gusto ko yung mga moves ko. Tapos, I am already expressing something like giving you a thumbs up to go ahead and call my daughter. Adwin, you still have a choice. Or in this case, Rachel, in the question, Rachel, you still have a choice. Kahit ba magtambing kami dalawang kaalwin eh. If you are very strong in your opinion that the Lord is leading you to someone else, then it will remain. Otherwise, I might be forcing myself on you. You follow Japan. But if we will confront it head on in our parents, Kuy-kuy, hindi mo pwede by design sa kuy-kuy. Are you following? In the vagina, not the vagina. It was really meant in reproduction and procreation to what? To supplement and complement each other. And that only happens within what? The sacred vows of animals. Nakakita na kayo ng tao na walang halik. Yung iba ay nagpapalit-palit. Yun ang labis. Yeah? So by design, God really created us to be what? To be married. So I hope it should not be mistaken as if God is forcing us to get married. What I'm trying to say, by design, we were made as social, emotional, sexual beings in order to enjoy the mystery of oneness.
When is the right time to consider or look for someone who will be your life partner? I can find it. Next. Okay. I'm 22 years old and we have mutual affection with a 31 years old guy. He is now stable in his life and I'm still studying. He is Adventist. What are those advantages and disadvantages? We said that we like each other, but he said he wants to grow me more. And I must know you too. Sometimes I can feel the feeling that I am lying. What would be your advice, Pastor?
When your circumstances does not point to a time that you're already ready, as it has been mentioned, we're still standing, the disparity of age is so wide, you have not exposure in comprehending what are the needs of a man at that stage. I guess these are issues you need to consider. I wouldn't say that my answer would be always the right thing. Go to someone you consider may speak the word of God who may have similar circumstances. What are the considerations? If the guy is much older than the woman, then you will begin to understand your circumstances. Maybe relative comparison of him. You will be able to see what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages. And if you pray faithfully to God, He will lead you to the right answers. Right now, I wouldn't say don't work that relationship with that guy with such a disparity. I am not certain of that. But there will always be advantages because you will be easily understood and provided space for mistakes of immaturities because you have a much older partner. But there are also excuses for that. You will need to weigh each of these and be able to come up with a good answer for you.
More
than one suitor. Unless it is in the respect of friendship, then I would say it should not be a Christian practice. Hindi po maganda. No? So, what would be better is that keep them in friendship. It should be in the context of friendship. If there are simultaneous expressions of this, wala ka magagawa. You never depended on them. If this happens simultaneously, or just one after the other, then this is something that you should consider. Am I already ready? It's not probably on the question of issue of can she entertain simultaneous. More likely, there will be simultaneous occasions when this happens. But think more attitude towards me. If it's in friendship, yes. But if it's already connected with another, and you entertain another one, then there must be a question. Oh, God. How right that would be. Because for me, equal to the circumstances of a man, it should not be entertained. When you have started affording equal affections to the man, then probably you would not want to obscure such things. I say, oh, we know that that one is for undividedness, single purpose. That would be very good.
Ano po yung
pastor?
Praise Christ, the love of God in us. Praise God that I hope even before we had this verse in our hearts, in our minds, in our lives, Jesus Christ, very much. He was the first one who had this verse. This verse because he has. Okay, let's proceed to the next question. In relation to that song, how do you deal with a very jealous girlfriend or boyfriend? To the point that you are very much suffocated with the regulations he, she does for you.
First, I would suggest kneel down in God's presence. There must be a message from the jealous partner. And there must also be a lesson to learn. So I would suggest kneel down, both of you, and ask God in prayer. If you can form a conversational prayer, then do it. Pour the intents of your hearts to God. Second, be open to an expectations assessment. The reason why jealousy may speak in a case like this is because communication is not expressed well or is not experienced by quality and quantity. It is probable that there was a communication but less quality. They may be talking, but there is no depth. And thus, without understanding each other, it is easier to go over expectations and be jealous. And then to control each other and suffocate each other. Second, there may be communication, but the quantity is not enough. So take an assessment. Go over the list of what are the important points that you should be talking about and check over a column of quality, quantity. Is for you this item enough on quantity? Or is this too shallow? Then note of that one. It will allow both of you to understand each other on your expectations. When jealousy is like this, within the marriage still happen, both should be towards resolving the seeming disparity. It couldn't only be one. Both of them should have an earnest effort towards resolution of that. If this is outside of marriage, and it is in a boyfriend-girlfriend relationship, this is a matter of priorities. The others might be taking priorities that are not the priority of the other spouse or the other partner. You may want to sit down together and talk over these disparities. And that will allow you to understand more and thus to give more space for each other to work on these issues. That's how I say it. In other words, the Bible says, let this time for everything.
Thank you.
God designed us in such a way that the man seeks the heart of the woman, and the heart of the woman is given to the heart of the man. That was a design after the fall. So you will notice that after the fall of Adam and Eve, God directed the satisfaction of the woman in the heart of the man, so that the longings of a woman will be after the husband. This design was placed in order to keep the relationship as God has purposed it. Not as an expression only of a curse in consequence of the disobedience of a woman, but primarily to teach a lesson. Now, in this respect, Rachel, it will be unnaturally for a woman to initiate a relationship that will lead to romantic covenantal relationship. Never do that. There will be many ways by which God can lead two praying individuals to meet each other and be bind and be bound for each other. But to destroy the paradigm and take each other's role in reverse, you are actually toying with God's design. So do not do that. It will still be better for the woman to seek persistently in prayer for God's leading, for a man that would rightfully come to her life, but also be in a place where God can work the answers. It is wrongful to be praying and asking God for the man of his choice, of his meaning, and you have that one placing yourself in the right spot. So when you ask for God's providence for that, then you should also be in the right place, in the right time. So when I say that, it is important to find yourself in the observance of the gentlemen among your friends. Because the mark of true friendship is where true love begins. You would like to be more open in your thoughts. You'd like to be more open in your life plans. You'd like to be more open in your preferences and what you consider as essentials. In other words, there is a way to make yourself available for such a relationship. But even as you pray, and you do not place yourself in a place where the Lord will deal with you to answer your prayers, then you are asking in vain. Kaya, you're 35 years old, kaya, I would suggest never give up on praying. You do not know the power of prayer. That just praying and introducing yourself, making the first move, allow God. Because often the scripture talks about wait in the Lord. Second, showcase the gifts that God has given you. humility to be exemplified, so that it will also invite of the same ministry. Never be disheartened that when no one comes around by the time you are 40 or even older, I give you up. God must have a special calling for you. You might be blessing some others' lives. How would you know it? If out of your sacred calling, you are profoundly blessing others, then you know that God is leading you to that kind of life. Pero kung yung mga tao sa paligid mo, naiiyak sa iyo, kuya na naman yung matanggap na langgap. Anong tao sa lakot? Eh, ang sama-sama ng tayo, kung galing ka sa mga kamatakan, o kung galing ka sa kahinay, you know? Your heart will not be balanced is a position to some. Kaya ba, ang mabuto, kung nag-alit natin ay kakawin, tumating sa ganong edad, and still without, what I'm trying to say, there is
also exemplify the same virtues. So
sometimes we impose it upon ourselves. Kaya may kasi may words dyan na dati, so ngayon, open na ako. Something like that. Basta tayo na very rigid. I would suggest na come to a posture where you see more of what God can do rather than the standards you impose. And probably that will open the way.
What is the very reason for here this afternoon? What is the very reason why you are here in this worship service? I believe majority of us would say that we want to learn. We all want to learn things with the Lord for His glory. But at the same time, the Lord also inspired me that maybe also have this way of thinking that we are here, we are all here because we are our brothers and sisters' keeper. Amen? And so we are not just here to listen, to benefit from this message. But I believe that the Lord purposely placed you in this worship because He wants you to extend the message, not just in words, but even with our lives. So for our last question, this is the question. I have a friend, and I don't know if he is trifling with words, because anyone who is acquainted with him tends to fall for him. He doesn't know how or why it just happens. What should I tell him? So, as brothers and sisters in Christ, how are we gonna tell to this person who is maybe not aware or even aware of what he is doing? What trick they with words?
She's very acquainted with the question. She might give in her own comments on that one. I believe this answer should get to him. This answer should get to him. If it becomes intentional after the realization, then it becomes his responsibility. Get it? If after realization he still becomes intentional about that, then it becomes his responsibility. Right now, we cannot judge the person. Siguro, siya'y ipong artista niya. And crush ng bata. Satan can also work to your disadvantage. So the warning and be sincere. Sincere counsel will often draw him to a deeper understanding of the situation. And when there is realization, there should be an intention to correct it. But if he persists on such thing, then that will be his responsibility. So, tonight, I am courageously finished all the questions. And I can end the Sabbath day with this ministry by saying, the Lord has sustained and the Lord has gifted us with understanding. I just hope that Satan, you didn't just give yourself up for this. You were mindful of all the conversations we had, of the answers we have considered, and making your practice as you prepare for rightful relationships. If for some reason you are already engaged, am I still connecting? If for some reason you are already engaged in a relationship right now, never despair. I would suggest pray to the Lord on impressions of what to do with a relationship, with a relationship as immature right now. You're not yet ready for that. With your circumstances right now, any relationship, boyfriend-girlfriend relationship right now, may not yet be ready for its challenges. My suggestion is don't blame it. Don't be seek God in prayer. Earnestly ask Him how to balance such a relationship now, if it could no longer be set aside in a meaningful friendship. Then ask God to help you consider every aspect of that relationship so that it will be sustained until you are ready to commit to each other rightfully in God's hands. Never ever resort to breakups until it will compromise your relationship with God. If these are only issues of preferences, then in humility, consider this on the table and evaluate yourselves. Breakups are not always solutions. There may be occasions that they could be, but usually breakups are not always solutions. You don't want in marriage to be resorting to what? To momentary breakups or temporary separation in resolving your problems. That is not the way to resolve conflicts. Because God's hands are never short to solve your relationship problems. He has always promised to take care of you. Never to abandon you. His love is on you. You are the apple of His eyes. So whenever problems like this come your way, never ever entertain the mind of Satan not to come to God. The more that you need in God in prayers. May the Lord bless your relationships, especially the friendships that you make now. May you make and enlarge your circle of true friends so that when the right time comes, among them, the Lord will lead you to that special Sabbath. And when it's God who leads you, it will also be God who will take responsibility of keeping your commitments for each other. Unless there are other questions, I'm done for tonight.